Whose fault?
I was never the one to believe in fairy tales. It was hard to have faith in relationships when everyone around you was filing for a divorce or going at each other's throats in trial fighting for custody. It just seemed that in the game of love, I would be a player that never wins. But I knew that I would be worse off if I didn't try. My mother always told me to never live with a man unless he was my husband. But coming from a woman who wants to divorce her husband every other week, I chose to pass on her advice. I knew that in the game of love, you had to take risks, and I had to test our relationship, and I was okay with that. I did not want to marry a man that I did not fully know. For all I knew, I could have been dating an irresponsible slob. I wanted to find out sooner than later. The morning of move-in day, I remember the world just felt different. The sun was brighter, the sky was bluer than I have ever seen, and the smell of the morning dew was the most refreshing that it has ever been. When Ken pulled up to my driveway, the butterflies started to dance inside of my stomach. He got out the U-Haul, and when our eyes met, I knew that we were thinking the same thing. There was a mixture of fear and anxiousness, as we both knew that this was a huge transition in our relationship. He walked closer, embraced me, and planted a soft kiss on my forehead. Then he whispered, "Are you ready?" with a smirk on his face. I smiled and said yes. I was as ready as I would ever be. We loaded all the boxes and furniture into the U-Haul. I never knew how much stuff I had until I had to pack it up and move it. We finished just in time for the harder portion of the day to begin. I was anticipating the unloading in this California heat to be excruciating. I said my goodbyes to my parents and we hopped into the U-Haul. The next stop was our condo at the homecomings. Once we arrived, I hopped out the U-Haul to pick up the keys from the office. However, Kenneth stopped me and said that he already got them. I was confused because I thought that we were supposed to do that on the day of move-in. But I guess it wasn't a big deal for him to be on top of things. I walked to the back of the U-Haul so that we could start unloading, but Kenneth stopped me again. He said that it was better if we unloaded when the sun started going down. It makes sense. I wouldn't want to suffer from heat exhaustion on our first day of living together. That would have been a disaster. Kenneth took my hand and we walked to our new home. We arrived at the door and he looked at me and smiled, but it was a nervous smile. Slowly he opened the door, and when I looked in, what I saw was the shock of a lifetime. I walked into a trail of roses that led into our family room. At the end of the rose petal trail, there was a DVD with a red ribbon tied to it and a note saying "Watch Me" attached to it. I picked the DVD up and played it on the TV. "Forever Ain't Enough" by Jay Holiday started playing, and pictures of the course of relationship started showing. Tears started to well up in my eyes. If I could have stopped in that moment in time, I would have lived in it forever. The slideshow came to an end, and he slowly walked towards the TV to turn it off. He turned around and walked towards me. Gently, he took both of my hands and gazed deeply in my eyes.
"Mariah, forever will never be enough for us. I will love you forever. You are the reason why I live. My only attempt is to make you smile. Promise. There is no mistake in the way I feel. Today, as we make this transition into our relationship, I want to show you that I am not trying to lease or rent your heart. I'm trying to own you. Mariah Elaine Harper, will you do the honors of becoming your wife?"
Of course I said yes. And from that point on, I knew that he was going to be the one that I was going to grow old with. Over the course of the next year, we learned so much about each other. I will not say that we were living a fairy tale, but he was my Prince Charming. A very messy Prince Charming, might I add. So Somehow his socks never made it to the hamper, and he can't seem to remember to put the toilet seat down. Sure, we get frustrated with each other and have to leave to get away for a while, but we always seem to make it back home. Knowing that we are preparing for a lifetime together makes it all worth it. Even if we fight over the little things, in the end, we make it better. The ring on my left hand is a reminder of how real our love is. Without it, I might not have put up with all his crap. He is my forever. Dirty socks and open toilet seats will never change that. The only thing I planned on changing is my last name. So today marks our 3-year anniversary, and I couldn't be any happier. Moving in together proved to be the right decision for us. I can't say that it is for every couple, because I have friends that didn't have much of a fairy tale wedding. I don't blame them. If marriage wasn't the end result, I would have left too. Kenneth has been the greatest gift to me. The day he proposed marked the day that my life became new with purpose. Through thick and thin, I was going to make our relationship last. Our marriage quality is perfect. If stability is a test, then our relationship is passing with flying colors.
Got the feeling that you can't seem to see where you wanna be. And lately it ain't been the same at all. When you're here, it's like I'm invisible. I still can't seem to see where I went wrong. Cause I'm take a shower then say I'm gone. What am I to do when my heart's asleep but my feet won't move? And today is our anniversary and you haven't even said 2 words to me. I'm trying hard to give you another chance, but ooh baby I'm feeling, I'm feeling really unappreciated.
But now